communication. So communication is nothing but the, like, I'm talking with you people and I'm sharing some of the knowledge which I have regarding the communication. So in the communication we are having one-to-one communication and also one-to-many. Okay, so one-to-one is nothing but a talk between two single persons. Okay, and one-to-many is nothing but one person is giving a lecture or something addressing the people. So the count is like this: one-to-many, then that communication is called as one-to-many communication. So in this we'll be having modes of communications. So we are having different types of modes of communications, like simplex, half duplex and full duplex. So in simplex, it is nothing but, a best example for this is nothing but a radio. So in this radio we can just hear. Okay, so we can't whatever in radio we are getting, that we can hear, but we can't respond to that and we can't give an answer to it. So then it becomes a simplex. In half duplex, I can give an example like walkie-talkie. Okay, so in walkie-talkie, what we'll be doing is nothing but we'll give an answer or we'll question, and after some pause, that person will be getting the answer from us. Then they will respond. So there is a time between the person who is talking and who are going to react. And the full duplex is nothing but a telephone or a mobile phone, where you can immediately respond to the person who is on the call. Okay, so these are the types of modes of communication. Okay, so modes of communication are simplex, half duplex and also full duplex. So mainly the communication is nothing but the person sharing the knowledge or saying any information or sharing the information from one person to the other person. It is nothing but the person who is talking will becomes the transmitter or transmitter, and the person who is listening, or where the voice signal or something will be receiving, is nothing but called as the receiver. Okay, so this is the person who is talking is nothing but becomes a transmitter, and the person who is listening becomes a receiver. Okay, so in this we are having types of communications. Okay, so in this types of communication we'll be learning about the analog communication and also digital communication. Okay, so in the analog is nothing but a continuous signal. Okay, if I consider a waveform like this, this is the sinusoidal signal, right? So this is like, if I'm continuously talking, that is nothing but the continuous signal, and also it is represented with the sinusoidal signal. Okay, so we'll be considering this in terms of voltage versus time. Okay, how bigger is my voice, that will be calculated with the terms of amplitude, and this is the time period. Okay, so and in this analog we'll be having this is the continuous signal, right? In the digital, this is nothing but we'll be calculating in terms of zeros and ones, means nothing but off and on conditions. Okay, so in the basing on this zeros and ones, the digital communication will be based on. Okay, so for any type of communication we need the modulation. Okay, so first we'll discuss what is a modulation, and later on we'll be discussing about the types of modulations. So modulation is nothing but we'll be changing the characteristics of a carrier signal with respect to message signal. Here, what is a carrier signal? So carrier signal is nothing but carry signal and also a message signal. Okay, so this can be written as C of T, and also this this can be written as M of T. So message signal is nothing but the in which this is a signal where we'll be having the information, and that should be reached to the person who is in the other end. Okay, so carry signal is nothing but a supporting signal. Okay, if my message signal, suppose I'm talking, right? So this voice signal cannot be reached to the person who is outside the room or something. So we'll be taking the help of a carrier signal. So message signal is nothing but a low frequency signal. Okay, so whereas the carrier signal is the high frequency signal. So we'll be taking the help of a message signal, help of the carrier signal, in order to send our message signal to the person who is in the other end. Okay, so like this will be this process is nothing but called as a modulation. So in this modulation, again we are having different types of modulations. Okay, so we'll be discussing about the different types of modulations. Okay, so in modulations we are having the angle modulation. Okay, and what do you call amplitude modulation, amplitude, and also phase modulations. Sorry, pulse modulations. Okay, so in angle modulations we'll be discussing about the phase as well as the frequency modulation. So in angle modulation we'll be having the phase as well as the frequency modulation. While coming to amplitude modulation, we'll be discussing about the amplitude modulation itself, and also DSBSC, which is nothing but called as double sideband suppressed carrier, and also SSBSC, which is nothing but single sideband suppressed carrier. Okay, in pulse modulations we are having three types of pulse modulations, whereas one is PAM, which is nothing but called as pulse amplitude modulation. Okay, and PPM, so this is pulse position modulation, and also pulse width modulation. So these are the three types of pulse modulations. Under modulations we will be discussing about the angle, amplitude, and also pulse modulations. So coming to phase modulations, so in the phase modulation it is nothing but the angle will be changed. As the name itself says, that angle modulation. So phase is nothing but we'll be having 0 degrees, 180, 90, like that we'll be having the angles. So if the waveform is zero, is nothing but it will be starting from the origin, and like this we'll be getting the output waveform. So later on we'll be we'll be seeing the experiments in our lab sessions, so we can come across what is the phase and all. Okay, so like 0 means the output will be starting from the origin itself, and 180 means it is nothing but will be like negative 0, right? Negative, in the negative quadrant will be getting the output, whereas 90 means will be getting the angle like this. Okay, so on will be writing the or will be getting the outputs according to our angles. Okay, so that is a phase. Whereas frequency is nothing but will be observing the change in the frequency. Okay, as I've said, that will be considering the carrier signal and message signal, right? So the carrier signal, its frequency will be very high, so the time period will be getting like this. Okay, so if it is a high frequency signal, we'll be getting the signal like this. If it is a low frequency signal, then the time period will be like this. So in the frequency modulation we'll be observing these two types of variations in one single output, so that becomes the frequency modulation. Okay, so and in the amplitude modulation for amplitude modulation and also the frequency modulation we'll be considering the bandwidth also. Okay, so in the amplitude modulation we'll be having three different cases. So what are the three different cases are like this. So we'll be this is my message signal. Okay, so and this is my carrier signal, right? So this is a message signal, which is nothing but M of T, and also this is a C of T, right? So So the output waveform we are going to get is in different three conditions we'll be getting the output. So it is totally based upon the mu value, which is nothing but called as the modulation index. Okay. So if it is greater than 1, what happens? If it is equals to 1 and if it is less than 1. Okay. So these are the conditions we'll be getting while we are performing the or we are observing the amplitude modulation. If it is greater than 1, overlap happens. Okay. And if it is equals to 1, it is called as the exact modulation. And also this is nothing but under modulation. Okay. So these are the different cases we are going to get based upon the modulation index. Okay. So see, this is the amplitude modulation and this is nothing but the modulation index. According to this, we'll be getting the outputs. Okay. So next is, so in this modulation index, so if we want to calculate what is this mu, how we'll be getting this mu, what is the mu? Mu is nothing but V maximum minus V minimum by V maximum plus V minimum, which is nothing but from our output signal. See, let me draw one case of the mu condition. So if I take the exact modulation, so see, we have to represent both this carrier and also the message signal, right? So if in the exact modulation, what happens is nothing but we'll be getting the signal like this. So upon this, we'll be getting the analog, which is nothing but in this is the carrier signal, which is the high frequency signal, and upon this we'll be getting as envelope, that is the message signal. So this carrier signal and message signal are traveling combined. Okay, so at certain point, what happens is nothing but they'll be getting overlap. Means, see, this is the overlap point where we'll be not having any this is nothing but from here to here we'll be saying it as the V maximum. Okay, so and V minimum is nothing but here we have to get. In the other two conditions we can observe, like in the overlap condition and also in the under modulation condition, we can observe the V minimum, but here we got the V minimum as 0, and let us consider this as to some 2 volts or something. So based upon these two values, like V minimum is 0 and V maximum is 2, we got, right? So based upon this, according to this condition which we have taken the values, we need to get new value as 1. Then it can be considered as, or it can be said as the exact modulation. So here we got like V minimum is 0, right? And V maximum we have considered as 2. So 0 minus 2 by 0 plus 2. So we can, 2 get can we get cancelled and we will be getting the new value as 1. So from this we can prove that it is an exact modulation. So yes, so this is all about the amplitude modulation. Okay, so next we'll be seeing about the double sideband suppressed carrier. Okay, so let me keep these signals as it is, because all the signals are based upon this message and carry signals only. In the DSBSC signals, we'll be getting the double sideband. Okay, so yes, so same, this overlap will be happening in this also. See, like this, we'll be getting. The envelope will be there and also the carrier will be present in this message signal. Okay, so for the single side band, so what happens is nothing but the bands will be like this, will be getting as normal signal only. Okay, so let me draw properly. So in this two conditions we can observe in the SSB, those are nothing but LSB and USB. Okay, this is nothing but upper side band and lower side band. So these will be totally based upon the spectrum of we are going to get. So this is F, right? So to this side will be saying as F minus S. Okay, and this is F plus S. So these are the functions we can see in the double side, sorry, single side lab. Okay, so this is all about the amplitude modulation. Okay, thank you.